Chapter 21, Citizens' Assembly. Full testimony from the Citizens' Assembly on the raising of taxes on the gridlock. Report number 231. Testimony from selected expert Dr. Clara Emmer, policy researcher at the Mech Institute. Thank you for calling these very important sessions. I'm sure we can resolve these concerns as soon as possible. I sit here today not just as the policy expert at the Mech Institute, but also as a member of the Emmer family. I understand that my closeness to them might affect how my statement is received, but I hope that my policy recommendations stand on their own. For those watching, I want to give the necessary background to understand the position of the Mech Institute. Several decades ago, some of you might still remember, the city ordered citizens to evacuate ahead of an impending climate catastrophe. Many of our grandmothers and grandfathers stood in that gridlock, leaving their homes behind. When the anomaly came and the rest of the planet went silent, given the circumstances, some of those in the gridlock weighed up their options to return by selling their spot in the gridlock. Home with a storm was safer than the anomaly. Amidst that chaos, the visionary of the public car markets, Stam Emmer, imbued order and bought the first cars. In providing this value to the city and its people, Stam Emmer realized that his efforts could be misconstrued as the entrenchment of a new market. As more cars were sold and left empty, Stam Emmer and other pioneers unintentionally exacerbated the gridlock. It was Stam Emmer, however, who realized this paradox and gifted us with the designs to formalize the gridlock into a public commons market. The Cars as Common Tax Initiative, or CACTI, was launched to safeguard our future and to generate enormous economic value for the city. Those who want to leave would fund those who want to stay. We turned the fear of the storm and the fear of the anomaly into hope. Because Stam Emmer owned most of the gridlock, he came to pay most of the city's taxes, a true public servant. Without him, we might still be stuck in an opaque market system, cars remaining in the hands of a few. I still believe our goal is a commons for us all. If necessary, we should all be able to leave this city one day, and thus we should keep the gridlock in the commons for as long as we can. It has funded our Hope Runner Championships, New Science, the Internal Dome, and the development of the city's cryptographic infrastructure. We should stick with this ethos. It is with that the Mech Institute's recommendation is the raising of the taxes on the cars in the public car market. We summarize our recommendation in three important points. First, our research shows that this would raise more revenue even while individual always-on-sale prices of the cars would decrease. Second, in bringing down the individual prices, we will give more owners the opportunity to own a part of the future and own a piece of hope. Finally, while the turnover of the cars will increase, the net gain will lead to a collective benefit. As the Hope Runners show us every 5 years, there's honor and pride in willing to sacrifice yourself for the collective good. It's something my own parents taught me, and I know it's a common goal for many of us. Those at the Mech Institute know the same. We are in this together. We have preempted critique of our recommendations by referencing concerns about increased turnover and increased taxes for individuals. We are not against the businesses and homes that currently exist in the gridlock, but we have to ensure that the cars remain in a position to evacuate at short notice. So yes, raising the tax rates on the cars will increase the turnover and potentially uproot citizens living in the cars. However, in doing so, the primary effect will be that it will bring back dynamism and flexibility to the businesses in the gridlock. The mid-levels force a sense of permanence to the value of the cars by essentially pigeonholing them into becoming shares of the concrete above them. In order to change, to build something new, requires extensive reconstruction that is often met with violent opposition from nearby car owners. Not only that, but we have seen that with the increased expansion of the mid-levels, unregulated business activity has increased in the trunks that result in overall less tax revenue for the city. This follows on to the next point about the effect on individuals. Due to a universal rise in tax rates, if people's risk appetite stays the same, always on sale prices should fall across the board. You will pay the same taxes. The new revenue will come from new dynamic economic activity. it can fund more advances in science and cover the shortfall of running the Hope Runner Championship this year. It is a week away, and I think I can speak for everyone in this city when I say we're excited. It fills us with hope. If we work together, we will achieve what we started several decades ago, to find our salvation and our answers. The Hope Runners are the key to this, champions that will sacrifice themselves for the greater good. We should be more like them. Undertake personal sacrifice to serve. For more detailed analysis of our economics and policies, you can find the documents online. These include our research and trade-offs between the allocative and investment efficiency, the models of increased tax revenue, the models of individual wealth creation, and the importance of ensuring that the gridlock remains a commons. If we allow concrete to swallow the whole city, we will never be able to leave. Thank you.